lighting the menorah. Where you should do it, the oil moed, Aaron should prepare it in oil moed, in the tent of meeting. It's a known question about this pasuk. In the Hasidic discourses of Lubavitch Rebbe's, since the lighting of the menorah was done by Aaron, why should they bring the oil to Moshe? They should bring the oil to directly to Aaron. The mashma shaviv Hashem and Moshe. When it says veikhu elecho, Hashem telling Moshe Rabbeinu to tell the Jewish people to bring to you olive oil to light the menorah. But since Aaron is the one to light the menorah, why does it say veikhu elecho to Moshe? It should have gone directly to Aaron. It's like almost like a middleman. Tell veikhu l'Aaron. Command the Jewish people to bring oil directly to Aaron. You're not lighting the menorah. So that's question number one. Question number two. Regam tzorich lo Moshe pasuk harishon gav veikhu l'lecho nemar la'aretz ne'er tomid pasuk sheni nemar me'erot breaker. One time the pasuk tells me la'aretz ne'er tomid, which means a constant light, a constant fire. The second time it says from evening till morning. So do you want the menorah to be lit from evening to morning only, or do you want the menorah to be lit tamid, constantly, the whole time? So that's the two questions that we have so far. Ulovin zet, to understand this, yesh lavo tchilo klo sein the shemen zayis. We need to understand what olive oil represent or symbolizes chassidically. Dein al pi amavua b'lusha b'yisein nuseinu. Teo, look at the Teo. Baruch HaEzer, Rikson, Shalim, Pesal, Danish, Bezu, Shnei, Fanim. Alter Rebbe, in the Kutat Torah, and Teo, discusses it at length. But there are two Eifanim. There's two things, two levels, two Inyanim, two concepts regarding olive oil. Eifan HaRishon, Shal Shemen, Unali, Yisum, HaZayit. One way is that the oil is higher than the olive, which we see that if you want to buy olive oil, it's more expensive than olives themselves. So oil is superior to the olives. The olive conceals and hides the oil that it contains. And that's why there is a need to crush the olives. In order to get the oil out of it. Binyan of Avodah, what it has to do with our divine service, the zayis, the olive represents is like the body and the animalistic soul that are generated from klipas nega, from the mixture of good and bad. The olive conceals the godly soul that is enclosed in it. So you have to crush it to make sure that the godly soul is expressed also. The godly soul is the olive oil. The animalistic soul in the body is the olive itself. And the godly soul, the neshama, is the olive oil. Why do you have to crush it? Same way you're crushing the olive to get the oil, you have to crush the body to reveal the eira neshama, kedesh le'alim ol eira neshama, so the body is no longer concealing the light of the neshama. Kemaimel zoya, gufa de sarik benero de neshmasa mevachin le. To mention the zoya, the Alter Rebbe writes it in Tanya in Perek Chavtes that a body that does not contain and not allowing the light of the neshama to penetrate, godly light to penetrate mevachin le, he has to go through bitush, he has to go through some kind of subjugation, some kind of chopping down, v'zeu gam masha, or humbling experience, v'zeu gam masha atam agashmi al-zayis, sh'nimshach mishtash minyon aruchni. It says in Chassidus, in a few places, that whatever we see in the world, or whatever exists in this world, is drawn down from its root, from its spiritual root. Everything has a spiritual source. For example, the sweetness that you find in an apple is rooted in chesed. the way it is in Atzilus. But Azayis, when it comes to olive, it says humar, is bitter. Humar, as soon as Al Apostle says regarding Yoino, that regarding the pigeon, the Yoino, the dove, that Noach sent out of the Teva, he sent out of the ark to check if the water subsided. And the dove returned, and he said, Ale Zayis Tov Vefir. And he said that she had an olive leaf in her mouth. Very small leaves, if you noticed, an olive tree. So she comes back with this olive leaf, and she said, Amro Yoina, the dove says, that's the prayer of the dove, of the pigeon, Yu mezoinoisai merurim, I prefer that my mezoinus, my sustenance, should be bitter like an olive, kezais. Here we see that olives are bitter. Shemirirus zu, and so basically a prayer, I'd rather to have bitter sustenance directly from Hashem than getting sweet sustenance from human beings. Shemirirus zu meiro al v'chinas chashecho meriru desitra acha. This bitterness represents the darkness of the other side, the side representing impurity, the side, the opposite of sanctity, of kedusha, of purity. That's what it says in the Gemara in Hayroyos Yud Gimel, that the olive can cause forgetfulness of 70 years of learning can be forgotten by eating olives.
Plain olives, right, without oil.
Yeah, it says if you don't pour oil on it. Vayinu the zayis, the concealment of an olive, u'ad kedei kach. It's so much so. Even though he learned for 70 years, he was learning. The life of man is generally 70 years. And his learning was properly. He didn't learn for ulterior motives and the like. Because if he learned for ulterior motive, it's good for him to forget it. If you learn for to use the Torah for negative things and the like, it's good for him to forget. We're talking about someone who learned lishma for its own sake, and he's still shaloch anikra b'Torah b'shem Talmud doy, meaning the Torah says the Torah uses the language, meaning the Gemara says that you will forget mashkech Talmud doy. He can forget, Meshakeach, he will forget Talmudoi, his learning, meaning that he learned Lishma, he learned for its own sake. Kuch Shazais, the power of the olive, Elam Vester, Guva Nevshabam, is to bring concealment to the body and the animalistic soul, which is a concealment of the body and the animalistic soul. Lashkiach Zois, to cause forgetfulness. Where does come we just learned that everything has a source in the spiritual world. Where does forgetfulness come? Comes from klippah, the world of klippah, the world of concealment.
But it's not fair. You learned 70 years Torah Lishma and you forget just because you eat
meeting olives. Yeah. Wait, it's not so. Good morning. Good morning. So, the lochin. That's why olives needs to be crushed. That's the concept of kosis, right? That we use in the Torah. It says this with Pasha, the Ratat the Tzavas Bnei Yisrael, you should command the Jewish people, Veikhu Elecha, they should take to you Shemen Zayis Zoch, pure olive oil, kosis lamoyev. Kosis is crushed to the luminary. Why does it need to be crushed? Loch, and Zichilus Mekisir Shazayis, that's why you need to have the crushing of olives. Shezeu Inyan the kosis, this is the meaning of Kosis, what is Kosis means to us? Subjugation, accepting the yoke of heaven. That's the idea of subjugating the other side, almost like forcing the other side to conduct itself in a certain way. The biwaguf and the shabamis, through elevating the body and the animalistic soul, separating the good from it, separating the good from the bad and elevating it to Kedusha. But deizim is gala shemen, and then the oil that is hidden in the olives is being revealed. Shiloi zubil vad sheinamar. Not only that, even though the olive is bitter, the oil that is in it, that comes through ketisha, comes through crushing, is not bitter. El adir avesh bunyana misikus, even has some sweetness to it. Shinyan v'sfiru subchina sachochma. Now, what is the source of oil? In the higher world is wisdom. Shilochen, when it comes to olive that can cause forgetfulness of 70 years. Machzir talmudei shel shivim shana. It can
opposite.
It can actually bring back the Talmud of 70 years. So that can answer your question. Since it has the capability of restoring the learning of 70 years, so far it's understood that the oil is higher than the olives. Because the union of shemen, of oil, is not just revealed wisdom. Ela gam bechinas chokhmas timar. Within oil you have two levels. The revealed, first of all, oil is wisdom, connected with wisdom. Oil itself, the olive oil. And within, so chokhma itself has the revealed wisdom and the concealed wisdom. Concealed wisdom obviously is higher. It's a level that is above revelation, concealed wisdom. And this is the concept of nullification to godliness. Bitul, nullification, is something that is higher than seichel, higher than intellect. Reifen, the second way, the second explanation according to Chassidus about olive oil. Shazai sulamalam Hashem. So far we learned one approach, one view, that the oil is superior to the olives. Now we're going to see that olives also have some superiority over the oil.
It's the
shortage. Olive has. It says, and olives are higher than oil. In the inner levels in the spiritual world, meaning in the source, since the zayis, the olive, is the source where the oil is coming from, the source of the oil, therefore is higher than the oil. This was written in Erkei HaKinuyim, Shar Erkei HaKinuyim, a book called Pardes. I think is connected with Rav Moshe de Ramak, Moshe Kodovero. Be'inyan nesoid uvinyan shema shelamata mekoyim v'tachtis. Said, whatever you find in this world and is v'tachtis, meaning is on a lower level in this world, in elamayla wa'ilun, in the higher world, is the higher one, is on top. K'ma yesoid shelamata v'tachtis abinyan. For example, the foundation of a building is in the bottom, seemingly the least important or the least significant. It's in the bottom. Aval lemailo, but in godliness, the yesod, the foundation, is madrego nalas yesod. It's much on a higher level. Like we learned about the adonim of the Mishkan. The Adonim also had the socket of the Mishkan.
Yeah.
So, one aspect, they were higher than everything. When it comes to an olive, it's the source of oil. According to the simple level, the simple meanings, the way they are down here in this world, olive is lower than oil. You go dig deeper in the essence of things, the way they are from above, from godly perspective, from divine perspective, the olives are higher than the oil. The more supremacy, the more greatness we attribute to the oil, which is the level of Chochmah, and also includes within it the concealed wisdom. In as Kanis Kale, as we just mentioned, in Azai Shu Mokir Hashem and Madrigo Nalasis, the olive that is the source of oil is the Madrigo Nalasis, so it's even on a higher level. Now we can understand the bitterness, the darkness that is within the olive. Why does the olive is so supreme? How come it has bitterness? It represents, it tells us, it hints to us about his great level, his superior level. What did we say? Shemen oil is wisdom. Now we're telling us that from divine perspective, olives, even though they're bitter, they're connected with kesa. Crown is higher than chochma. Chochma is the head. Above the head is the kesa. So the olives are higher because they are kesa.
I think we learned in Chassidus before about Purim. The Aichelo Yada is Keser, right? Which is above Chachm, right?
The same analogy could be...
One second, but so he says, how come is it representing bitterness and forgetfulness? If it's Aleph, it's forgetfulness and bitterness, if it's Keser. So it says, because what is Keser? In Keser, it says, Yoshes Choshech Sisra. We mentioned this passage a few times. Why is it called choshech? Why is it called darkness? Not because it's really darkness, because it's so much, it's so far removed from revelation. It's so concealed that we call it choshech. We call it hidden. Not that it's truly darkness. Not that it's truly bitter. It's just it's so high, it's so hidden, it's so concealed that we call it choshech from our perspective. It's not something we can see. That's one interpretation. There's another interpretation that it's that on that level, darkness and light is the same. Because the whole idea of time, of place, of limitations, so when you lower yourself into the realm of the world, but you look at it from above the world, these two levels can mean the same thing.
Probably the same analogy could be said about the Father and the Son. Even the son is a very important, but the father is the source.
Right.
Should be respected, should be put in.
Right, that's why the Torah asked the children to respect their parents. But it says, Yofikach Abin Mikrach Av, the power of the son is greater than the power of the father. Many times the son reveals what the father has in his potential. Father has it in potential. And the child brings it in actual. He brings it in actuality. So it says, that sometimes the power of the sun is greater. But obviously there's two ways to look at it. Like we see with oil and olives.
Rabbi, the blind judge that came here talking about people that had like special needs, saying that they go through a very like bitter life, you know, really struggling to life, but that a lot of these people, they really have like very high neshama, like very high neshamas that come from a lofty source, but the vessel, you know, is they just go through a very bitter life, and through that they're able to like really surpass and become like great people.
Right. I heard that this might be connected to this. I heard a rabbi who said that the people who listen to very like jumping music and very like hyper music, happy music, people that are deep inside and not happy. People who listen to more of a slowed down, more of a happy, maybe even depressing music that we sound to others, is people that are happy inside. Meaning what you do on the outside is the opposite of what is done
you
inside.
You see that around here, I'm not going to say who, but you see that around here. That people that, some people tell jokes all the time, but they're really not the...
Like, what's his name, that killed himself, it was a famous...
Comedian, yeah, Robin.
Comedian.
Robin Williams, yeah, but he's...
He made everybody laugh, but he himself was depressed.
Well, but he knew he had a terrible disease and whatever. I mean, it was a complicated situation.
That's a crazy phenomenon.
But it had a complicated situation. I'm not taking... You're right, but there was more to it.
Anyhow, ויש לו אמר שבזה תולו גם פירוש לשמן זית זוך. We see the interpretation of when Hashem is commanding Moshe to bring olive oil, but it has to be zach, it has to be pure, clean. Im zach kaya la shemen, pirush rashi, if the word zach, pure, is referring to the oil, pirush rashi, sheyesh bo gam seiros hatorah. You know that the interpretation of rashi, embedded within Rashi's interpretation, secrets of Torah. You have to look deep into Rashi. That's why the Rebbe called the commentary of Rashi Yeina shel Torah, the wine of Torah. Because you have to really drink it to find the secret in it. You have to dig deep into it. Rebbe has books and books over Rashi, on the commentary of Rashi, why Rashi chose this interpretation and not something else, why Rashi deviated from his pattern in certain areas. Like if you learn the system of Rashi, you see sometimes there's slight deviations in wording and expressions, things he would usually not explain or would not elaborate and suddenly elaborates, so adding words here and there in his commentary. There'll be as long discussions of Rashi commentary, sometimes even complex discussions on Rashi's commentary. So Rabbi called it Yeinashal Torah, and Rashi says, Shemen Zayit Zach, that the word Zach is referencing to the oil. Zach, Blishmo, what does it mean when we, Hashem is asking Moshe Rabbeinu to bring oil to light the menorah in the Mishkan? He says, I want the oil not to have any sediments, not to have any shmorim. Yeah. But you have to sift it many times, right? It makes sure that there's nothing in it. Or maybe Zach is referring to the interpretation of Ibn Ezra. Ibn Ezra says that no, Zach means that the olives themselves should be clean. The olives need to be pure, not the oil. And even Rabbi says that even the commentary of Ibn Ezra has secrets of Torah. We see that the interpretation of Ibn Ezra was adopted many times into Hasidic discourses, some of his commentaries. And there's a commentary of the Mital Rebbe. We just learned yesterday the Ayom Yom of the Mital Rebbe, that he had such a prolific mind. That he used to, when he gave his Hasidic discourses, he used to do shah, shah, shah to quiet people. But he didn't really quiet people because they're all silent. But he said, it says over there that he was quieting his gushing thoughts. His mind was so prolific that he had tremendous of ideas coming to, at the same time. And he had to shush his own self, to calm it down so he can continue on in a limited way so they can understand what he said. But even then, his Hasidic discourses are very complex and very lengthy. So the point is that the Mital Rebbe himself says about the Ibn Ezra, that the Mital Rebbe said about him that he gave up his life, and Kiddush, he sanctified his life. Kiddush Hashem, sanctify his life for the sake of Hashem. And he says that we need to take the oil for the Beis Hamikdash, Hagargirim, take the gargir is usually a reference to the seeds. The point is, it needs to take olives that are pure. There's no rotting in them. They were never eaten or not touched. And from these types of superior olives, they need to make the oil.
Mainly from the top we know, of the tree, you know?
We know.
Yeah,
it says superior olives. Whatever it is that it superior olives. But over here it says, chain boim ipush, no rotting in them. Ipush is rotting. Something that is mitapesh, it starts to be moldy. So it means in Hebrew. And shalom nechlak tosam, that nothing was eaten from them. So it needs to be good olives. We know that when you crush olives, the first drop that came out of the olive, that's the drop that they used for the menorah. The other drops were used for other things.
They don't say about blemishes? In the
so olives? We have two interpretations of what is the word zach means. Zach, the simple meaning in Hebrew, zach means pure. But what does it mean, pure? Pure oil or pure olives? Oh. Clean. Supreme oil or supreme olives? According to Rashi, it's supreme oil. According to the Ibn Ezra, it's supreme olives.
But if you bring perfect olives, you cannot make fire. Only with oil. To the menorah with
oil. Right. No, but you're talking about the word zach. Okay, it says shem and zayit. The shaman, you need to have olive oil. Everyone agrees you need to have olive oil to light it. Rashi and the Ibn Ezra. But Rashi said, what is the word zach there in the Torah coming to teach me? Okay. Comes to teach me the oil has to be pure, clean, supreme. And according to the Ibn Ezra, he says zach is referring to the olives. The olives that you're going to crush to make oil needs to be a superior level.
Does Rashi contain the other one within it? Like, to have pure oil, you have to have clean, pure olives, and then you also have clean oil. But if you have pure olives, might have sediments in your oil.
No, but even though you have pure olives. You can still get an oil. You can still get oil from an olive that somebody took a little bite. You can still, I can still take some oil from it. Why not to use those olives? So according to the Ibn Ezra, you can't use it. According to Rashi, the main thing over here, my main focus is on the oil. But even as I focus is on the olives. The olives have to be checked and superior. We'll see why they each one choose to interpret the word zach in such way. According to the simple meanings of things, we just mentioned it before, that the olive that conceals the oil, olives contains the oil, it's representing the body and the animalistic soul that hides the godly soul, that hides the neshama. So you have to have you have to be very scrupulous, very careful with choosing, with picking the olives. Meaning, picking the olives, where are you going to get the oil? You have to be very careful with choosing those olives. Shazayis atzmo yezach, that the olive itself needs to be pure, as the interpretation of the Ibn Ezra. Yikasher azayis eino zach, if the olive is not pure, vayinu shaguf vanev shabamis eino mezukochim klal, and this would mean that the body and the animalistic soul are not refined, are not pure. Elam b'toikif achumrius, so what, in what state they are. Toikif achumrius means that they are on their highest level of coarseness. They are very coarse, the body and the animalistic soul. They were not refined. It's like the olive that is not good. What did we say in time? And what does the Zohar say? That the way to deal with a body that does not allow the light of the neshama to penetrate, and you have to do some kind of crushing, some humbling. But if the body is so coarse, it's like, and he gave the example of a log. Right, so a log cannot catch fire unless you chop it down, right? But if the log is humongous, you can't even chop it down. You need to have special machinery chopping down by itself is not going to do it.
You saw it up and then.
It's very hard to deal with it. So he says, what happened if the body and the animalistic soul are so coarse or so stuck in their ways that it's going to be very difficult, that the mevachin, chopping it down, is not going to do it. For example, the klipa of Amalek. You can't deal with Amalek. Why does it say, Timche Zecher Amalek? We have to eradicate the remembrance of Amalek.
Kim.
Why not to elevate? Why not to work with it? Okay. Certain klipas you cannot elevate. Shein shum dovo Amalek. There's nothing. It says, El Shviros, like we say about clay. Clay pots.
To break.
You have to break them. That's a tikkun. You can't say, okay, I'm going to clean it, purify it.
The Alter Rebbe says about Machshava Zoras, the measure of Sadik, you shouldn't try to elevate them because that's only the Sadikim can do that and you shouldn't pay attention to them, right?
Right. It's like, don't try to think, oh, why did I have that thought? Maybe it's coming to tell me something. So don't contemplate on it. You have a negative thought, reject it. So don't try to elevate it. You can't, a tzaddik elevates negative thoughts of other people, but he doesn't have his own negative
thoughts. And not to debate missionary.
That's another issue. It says, amenavel misnuvel misnabel. If you're dealing with a manuval, with a
dirty person,
you become dirty yourself.
Right. So.
Like walking into a perfume store, coming out with good smell, walking into a store that smells bad, you're coming out with a bad smell. So you'll be affected by it, that's the point. So therefore, we need to make sure that the olive itself will be pure and refined. And then the crushing would help. So last is, so if we want to become a kli to godliness, we have to make sure that the body is pure. That the animalistic soul itself is we worked with it and is refined.
Get rid of the bad first.
Yeah. Aval mitzat pnimius ha'inyonim, but if you go deeper, pnimius ha'inyonim, to the inner, deeper level of things, sha'azayis u'b'chinas yoshu choshes yisroi, the zayis, we said, it's kesel. Darkness that is above revelation, light that is above revelation, shulamala gamayor shachlish tashus ha'ilomois, which is above light that is even connected with the world. Meaning, there's a godly light that descends and comes down from one level to the next. When it comes to the olive, it's referring to a level that is above Ishtalshulus, above coming down to the world. And this is the highest level of sanctity, the highest level of holiness and nullification. And then there is no need to be so careful, so meticulous about choosing the olive itself. The only thing that we have to be careful is about the oil that is generated from the olive, which is the light that comes from Seder Ishtalshlus, from the regular order of degradation. Lebechinas Chochmah goes into the level of Chochmah, the first level within the godly manifestation. Shehi, the level of wisdom. Shehi Reishis Agilu Vishtalshulus. This is the first level. Wisdom is the first level in the order of degradation. Veeshlo Shaychus Loilomis, and it has connection with the world, not like the Zayis, olive that is above the world. And that's why the being meticulous about the oil is more important. V'abitul, and the nullification will be clean from any other kinds of mixtures. Zach blishmorin, without any sediments, pure without any sediment, like Rashi interpretation, Yeina Shotero, Rashi's interpretation, which is called the Yeina Shotero, the wine of the Torah, which represents secrets. Inyan asoid v'aprimus v'aprimus v'atero gufa, the inyan of secret, the inner levels of Torah, v'lochem v'vorosh v'apipnimus ha'inyon. So far, we see that the interpretation of the Ibn Ezra We need to be meticulous about the olives, and the interpretation of the of Rashi, you need to be meticulous about the oil. It's really going back. He said each interpretation has deep meanings in it. So interpretation of Ibn Ezra tells us you have to be careful about the olives. You have to make sure, because the olives are rooted in Kesser, you want to make sure it comes from a level that you can deal with. That the bitu, the chopping down would help it somewhat, would help it, and then you can get oil out of it. Rashi says, I'm dealing with the oil. I'm dealing with the oil because this is what we're going to light the menorah. And I have to be meticulous about the oil. That should be clean from any kinds of mixtures. לפי שמצד ספירס החוכמו שמן אין מוקר מציר של דובר זו. Because from the aspect of חוכמו, which is oil, there is no room for anything that is foreign to it. חדוע, it's known, שבואי לו מהצילוס, we talk about the world of הצילוס, the world of emanation, שכלולוסו בחינס החוכמו. That in general, it says in explaining חסידוס, that there is a division, a general division between the four worlds. Although each world has the 10 manifestation, 10 spirit within each world, each one has 10 spheres. But what is the dominating sphere in the world of Atzilus? It's Chochmah. Olam HaBriyah, in the world of Briyah, in the world of creation, the dominating manifestation is Bina, and the world of Yetzira is Midos, the emotive attributes, and the world of Asiya, the dominating level is Malchus, kingship. So each one has its dominating sphere. So what happens in the world of Atzilus? Chochmah. What does it say about the world of Atzilus? Lo yegur chara, that no evil will befall you. Meaning it's a world that has bitul nullification. There's godliness there, revealed godliness in Atzilus. But there's no room for evil. There's no evil within Atzilus. Once you get to the world of creation of Bria, there's a little bit of evil. But going to the lower world, Yetzirah, there was 50-50. You go to the world of Asiya, our world, there's more bad than good. Also, why is it the world of Atzilus has no room for evil? It's just because there's a revelation of the Ein Sof. The Ein Sof is infusing itself directly into the world of Atzilus. But since the world of Atzilus is a world, if I call it a world, means that it has relations to other worlds. Has relations to the other worlds, is a possibility of sediments, of a little bit of a mixture, not being 100% pure, no evil, but some sediments. And for the oil that are considered, for the oil that we are looking for to produce for the menorah, it's considered foreign. It's a foreign. It's zar instead of zah. It's foreign instead of pure. So, this is the level of Chochmah itself, wisdom itself. So, when it comes to Ruchnius, to spirituality, and Sfiras HaChochmah, the level of Chochmah, since it has connection to the world, we need to make sure that there is no foreign mixture within the world, within Chochmah itself, within Atzilus. Meaning that nothing there should exist that is not completely nullified to godliness. Mikol sheken, mizeh she'afir, then again the Chochmah stimo, even when it comes to the concealed wisdom, ita b'zoya, it says in the Zoya, the shokit v'ishtakich ba'asri kechamar tav adurdiya. It says in the Zoya about the concealed wisdom, that is obviously higher than regular wisdom, then it says, shock, it's silent, and it's sitting in its place like good wine that sits over its sediments. Wine, meaning even the concealed wisdom, the Zohar says that there is some kind of sediments there within the concealed wisdom, the higher level of Chochmah. Shayach inyan shel shmorim. There's still some kind of shmorim, something that is not 1,000% pure. V'chol de shayach inyan shem, and this is only possible into the oil itself. Chochmah. Mashen kibinyan b'chinas chochmah. Mashen kibinyan azayis shemekochom olo shayach afulin shel shmorim. When it comes to the olive itself, which is above chochmah, it says there's no room for any sediment. So we see that in a way, the interpretation of the Ibn Ezra, that the focus should be on the olives, he says, because the olives are keser. But what is more special about the olives?
No sediments.
There's no sediments. There's no room for anything negative in there. And therefore, there is no need to, according to Rashi, there's no need to warn me that the zayis needs to be zach, the olive needs to be pure, because the olive is already pure. And Rashi says, I want you to look at the oil. Because the Zayis, I'm not worried about the olive. I'm worried about the oil. Because the oil is Chochmah. And Chochmah has the potential of having Shmolim, of having sediment. We'll continue tomorrow.
Wow. Deep session. We are responsible for Atzilut also?
We are. Everything we do affects all the world. Thing you do affects Adam Rishon did not just create a damage here. Really? Welcome to you.
Yeah, I was going.